I'm Katie Wang, and welcome back to my channel. This video is probably about my favorite dog in the world. It is about my favorite dog in the world, aka it's a whole video about Oxer, because Oxer is my personal Australian Shepherd. First off, I want to say if you're new here, welcome. I hope you enjoy your stay, and if you're not new here, thanks for being part of the fam bam. I appreciate you. But right now, I am 19. I got my first dog, Oxer, at the age of 13. We were in love, and he was the cutest little puppy. And he actually has been the biggest blessing in my life. He became my service dog when I really struggled with anxiety and stuff like that. He just really helped me out, and I love him so much. And he's probably the best dog I've ever met, but I'll never own an Australian Shepherd again. Reason one is because they're super high energy and protective naturally. And two is because no one's gonna compare to Oxer, and I know that personally. So, here's all the info on Australian Shepherds. So, Aussies are known for being stoic, energetic, and social. They have this weird quality where they're super high energy and want to go, 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 but they're so like calm and collected at all times. So, it's a kind of interesting balance. They're also a herding breed and are known for their need to have a job. They were bred to herd animals. So, because of this, they want to have a job. They want to run in the fields for 16 hours a day. So a lot of people want them because they're so pretty and the merle coats are gorgeous. But realistically, it takes a lot to fulfill an Australian Shepherd. And I think this is something that not a lot of people realize, because you see like a well-trained one, and a lot of times even people comment on my videos with Oxer and are like, oh my gosh, she's so well-trained, I want one. But there's so much work that goes into getting them to that calm point. They're also extremely intelligent, which makes them really easy to train and really challenging to train. I know that sentence didn't really make sense, but they're like easy to train when it comes to the basics. At 8 weeks old, my Australian Shepherd knew sit, down, stay, roll over, play dead, sit pretty, and shake. Like, he knew everything within the week I got him. But they also can be a little bit more challenging to train because they know the boundaries and they'll outsmart them and they're stubborn. So like, for example, if you give your Australian Shepherd way too much freedom right away and give them room off leash, they might go a little bit further and not come back exactly when you call them if they know that you're gonna stick around. So they're a really smart breed. I think one example of Australian Shepherds just being extremely intelligent is Oxer. First thing I do, I have a cat named Zesty. I found outside she was abandoned, and she eats like she's still abandoned. She was so skinny when I got her, and she just loves food so much. She has no portion control. The first thing I do every single day is put the cat food on the counter, and I then get ready to walk dogs and start my day out. And because of that, I go into the bathroom right away. I open the can of cat food, go into the bathroom, brush my teeth, do all of that stuff. Then I come out, and the cat food's always gone, it's always back on the counter. Well, one day I came out and Oxer heard me and was putting the cat food back on the counter. So, needless to say, Oxer knew that I wouldn't be able to tell he was eating the cat food if he put it back on the counter. And I feel like most dogs wouldn't comprehend that, wouldn't have that thought process, but Australian Shepherds really are always one step ahead, and I think that's when it really hit me, like, wow. Aussies are very smart. People don't just say that for no reason. I need to disclaim this because I think Australian Shepherds are an amazing breed. Oxer has been the biggest blessing in my life. I couldn't thank him enough. Like, the day that dog dies, I'm dead. I love him. So I'm gonna say a lot of cons about Aussies, but this is really just the realistics about Australian Shepherds and what it takes to fulfill them. Why not to own an Australian Shepherd debunked? Because they're great dogs, but you need to know what you're getting into. So the first thing I wrote down was just how easy they are to train versus how hard they are to train. Like, they're so easy to trick train, but teaching them to listen and be consistent can be a little bit more challenging if you give them too much freedom early on. So you want to just make sure that you're giving your Australian Shepherd a lot of structure as a puppy and not that much freedom until they're past the age of one or two. And I think that's really important. Okay, another con about an Aussie is some people would say they're not the best family dogs. Not because they're aggressive, but because they are one person dogs. And what I mean by this is Australian Shepherds really only get that special bond with one person or a select few. So for example, my dog is very attached to me. If I'm not there, he's super depressed and I work with him, I walk him, he sees me as the provider. So if he's with my dad or my boyfriend or my sister, he's okay, but he's whining and he's not as well behaved. He just is used to being right next to me. So if you want a dog that's gonna equally love every person in the family, you might wanna look for like a lab or a Doberman or something like that, or a Rottie. But Australian Shepherds genuinely get super attached to select few people. So if you have a huge family and you want them to love everyone equally, it's not your best choice. Also, because of this, they are so bonded to the select few people that they become highly protective. And I think a good story for this is when I was 15 and a half, maybe 16, I wanted to have boys over and my Australian Shepherd lost it. And now I train dogs, so he's perfect with everyone now, but at that point in time, it was a free-for-all. He was so mad. He would not let them in the door. He was growling and barking and trying to attack them. Like, he did not want the boys near me, which I think my dad was grateful for, but I think that's a good example of why it can be a challenge. Like, it can just be challenging, and you just have to make sure you socialize them and make them okay and get them to the point where they know a person's okay if you invite them in. Another note is Australian Shepherds, since they're so protective, can be wary of strangers. So it's just so important with this type of breed that's naturally a little bit apprehensive to socialize them early on and make sure that they know people are okay. Another tip that I think a lot of people don't know about is in America, we want to like put our hand out and let a dog sniff us and be like, be our best friend, because dogs are cute, especially Aussies. And if you have an Australian Shepherd or see an Australian Shepherd in public that's a little nervous, what I would do if I was the owner is make my dog sit and be like, hey, he's not gonna get pet right now, because what that will do is teach your dog that you can take him out in public and nothing that's going to stress them out beyond return will happen to them, and it'll give them more trust in you. Also, if you're a person, when you're going up to a dog, even though you think you're being respectful and putting your hand in their nose and letting them sniff you, it can be a little bit more scary for them and it can frighten them, because the dog space is respect. So you're taking space away from them, and that can get them in that fight or flight mindset where they'll try to run away, they'll get super scared, or they could get really protective and start growling and trying to nip. So what I would do is just make sure in public you're always giving Aussies a little bit more space when they're nervous. My Australian Shepherd is personally very friendly towards other dogs, but as a dog trainer, I've noticed it's really common for Aussies and Aussie mixes to be selective with other dogs and also to not be a fan of other dogs or be super reactive to other dogs, especially on walks. What I think this is a product of is a dog not being properly mentally and socially and physically fulfilled. What I mean by this is your dog isn't getting socialized enough, which is leading them to output their excessive energy onto other dogs. So what I think is really important, especially with such a high energy dog that can get to such an intense state of mind so quickly, is if you have friends, ask if you can pack walk your dogs with the Australian Shepherd. Just give your Australian Shepherd structured activities to do with other dogs so they're not taking all their natural excitement and outputting it onto the other dog and then not knowing how to interact properly. A lot of it is just managing your dog's excitement and keeping them at a calm level when they're socializing so they don't feel that intensity that makes them nervous. And when he barks, I won't go, Oxer, shut up! And I mean, sometimes I get frustrated and I'm like, Oxer, and then I catch myself. And I find what's worked super well is if I walk out there and I'm like, Oxer, come here. Make him, he's right there. He just looked at me. Hi, Bubbas. Naturally, they're protective. You have to accept that they're doing what they think is right. So instead of reprimanding them for it, call them over. Like I said, Oxer, come here. He sits here. I look around the yard with him. Just for a second, I'm like, Okay, good boy. Enough, walk in. So what that does is it tells him that I noticed what he noticed, even though I sometimes didn't, and it reassured him that everything's cool, and then he stops. Another con with Australian Shepherds is their grooming requirements. This is because they're double coated, which means they have an undercoat and an overcoat, a top coat, not an overcoat, I'm so stupid. So an undercoat. This is where all the dead hair accumulates and everything like that. So instead of just being shaved down or clipped, it's actually best to really blow out the dog's undercoat. So you use a really, really heavy duty, blow dryer, a dog blow dryer, and blow out their coat to blow out all the undercoat. So then all you have left is the shiny top coat, If you don't blot their undercoat, that's when you'll start seeing like those bunches of hair and all that stuff coming out from their, on top of their top coat, but it's like from their undercoat and it's just like trying to blow out naturally, but they can't really do it naturally. So that's why they have such a pretty coat, but it's also a lot of work. To summarize, Aussies are not your normal couch potato dogs. They'll watch a show with you for 5 minutes and then they're ready for a game of fetch. They're ready to do some obedience. They want to be stimulated. And Aussies are super mental. They love to learn and they love to work. So you're not just gonna run them out on a bike and have them be tired for the rest of the day. You need to really work with them, really get them engaged mentally. Take them everywhere with you. They're not gonna be on the couch with you most of the time. If you have an Australian Shepherd, please comment down below if yours is cuddly, because mine, Oxer, likes to sleep next to the bed and it makes me so sad because I just want to snuggle with him, but thankfully my Dobermans are snuggly. Also, I have a fishy tank. I'm in the middle of that video. I filmed the setting up, the doing the water, everything like that, the loading it up, the buying it.
Ah! We back, baby.
Work. My light isn't working. Thank you so much for watching. I love you and I will see you next video. Bye! By the way, I fake tan my hands. Look at this. I didn't have my mitt and I messed it up. Yikers. Okay, the dog not being naturally they're I'm like, I got distracted.
Oxer, lay down. I have your ball and a cheek. How hard is this?
Jazzy. To summarize. I feel like such a mess today. To summarize, I have a fishy tank.
Hi, guys.